All right, welcome back. Sports Chat.
503 from the southeast of Portland.
That's right. Oregon. Southeast side of Portland. Okay, one of my favorite basketball players growing up, absolute stud, Ed O'Bannon.
Enunciate, very good.
Ed O'Bannon.
There you go. Ed O'Bannon, UCLA. I got to see him play in Seattle, win the national championship over Arkansas. They had Scottie Thurman and Corliss Williamson. And, yeah, awesome.
That was on their repeat mission, huh?
Toby Bailey. They had Cameron Dollar, Ty Sedney, J.R. Henderson, Jelani McCoy. I was a bit of a fan.
Yeah, that was a good squad.
Yeah.
Okay, so Ed O'Bannon happens to be suing the NCAA. Mm-hmm. His image is being used to sell the NCAA merchandise without his permission. He's taking up the cause for all the other athletes this is happening to.
Yeah.
And at the moment, I don't really know where this is going. I don't know what this is. But we're here to talk today about the idea of the NCAA using athletes' images without their permission to sell their merchandise, to pimp their products, to make money. So does the school make money? Does the NCAA make money? Can the players make money? Can the players make money when they're no longer players? Take, for example, J.J. Redick. J.J. Redick is one of the greatest all-time athletes ever at Duke.
Duke, going to win it this year. Tournament all the way.
Can J.J. Redick make money off of Duke merchandise that has his name and number on it, or just number, because a lot of the merchandise for college, they don't have the name on it.
Yeah.
After he becomes a professional. Obviously, there's a whole tampering issue with when they're an amateur,
right.
But after they're professional. The Ed O'Bannon thing to me is so interesting because Ed O'Bannon was so good, so dynamic, so fantastic, and yet very unknown, I think, today in today's modern, younger version of the NBA fan.
Yeah, as a college player and, you know... He only played a couple years in the NBA for like the Nets, I think.
Yeah, I think he had like leg issues, maybe some knee.
He had some knee problems. Yeah, you're right.
But dynamic player. I mean, you know, kind of like a, like you were saying, almost a Garnett. I'm saying like a smaller LeBron. I mean, he's big. He's stronger and he could post people up bigger than a Kevin Garnett, but he could than a Kevin Durant, but he could score like Kevin Durant.
Yeah.
But he could post people up like a Kevin Garnett. I mean, dude was for real.
Yeah, maybe a little Lamar Odom in there.
Yeah, kind of a Lamar.
Yeah.
Yeah, kind of a Lamar, exactly.
Yeah.
But better, I think.
Yeah, a little bit slider frame, but
I think better.
Yeah, I agree.
I think he was for real.
Yeah.
Okay. Should the NCAA be able to give their athletes money years after the fact? These people are in movies. They say two or three things in movies. They get these checks for months and months and months
for
the rest of their life.
Yeah.
Why can't a guy like a... How many times have I seen Christian Laettner with the turnaround jumper?
Yeah. Yeah.
My aunt was at that game.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Dang.
East Rutherford, New Jersey.
Wow. Duke, Kentucky.
Yeah. But how many times have I seen that?
Yeah.
And Laettner hasn't seen $1 from that, has he?
Yeah, I don't think so.
And Duke has a lot of free advertising from it.
Yeah. Yeah, and, you know, like you were saying, there's a lot of different, like, levels or layers to this. Like, the first one that comes to my mind is that I think that the players, they get full ride at a college, you know, housing. They get to travel around the country, things like that. They get tutors that go with them so they can pass their classes. So I think that's payment enough for them for playing basketball and... the school being able to use their likeness
for sure
and using them for marketing or selling jerseys
during the time they're there.
That's right. And then there's another level like you're bringing up that was but after, you know, after their time there, it's not even necessarily, it's not the school really that's making any money. It's more the NCAA that's making money from shirts or jerseys or videos. And, you know, you have a company like Nike, they'll put out a bunch of old retro college jerseys.
Or so, even like this year, for example, let's say Rose Bowl.
Yeah.
Nike puts out Terrell Pryor jerseys. There's all sorts of red number twos out there. And there's all sorts of green number eights out there.
Yeah.
So Nike makes tons of money off of the sales.
Yeah, Nike's getting most of that money. But
the NCAA gives money as a revenue to use the product.
But Yeah, and but, you know, in that situation, we don't even really know if any of that actually goes to that school because...
Yeah, is Ohio State making that much money off all those number twos? Yeah. Or are they just making the money that they're selling off of the ones from their distributorship?
Yeah.
In their stores, at their games, at their fan shops.
Yeah, so it's so many different elements to this, but...
Should Terrell Pryor be able to have some money made? When Terrell Pryor graduates, should there be some sort of a bank account set up somewhere that has some money set aside for all those number two jerseys that are out there? There's a lot of number two red jerseys out there. I saw them in the NCAA tournament watching Ohio State lose.
Yeah.
I saw them there.
Yeah.
Terrell Pryor hasn't seen $1. He can't see $1. He can't see pizza slice number one.
Yeah, and, you know, the whole idea of being amateur versus professional, so you're getting paid, kind of gets mixed in there. Like, my opinion is, after he graduates and he's no longer, you know, benefiting from the university, you know, through scholarship, things like that, I think he should be able to get a cut of anything that's sold with his likeness. But at the same time, I think one way that the schools can get around that, or the NCAA, is, like you were saying, a lot of the stuff you see, like jerseys, doesn't have a name on it.
Right.
So, yeah, even though J.J. Redick wore number, was like 24 or something at Duke.
Yeah.
All they'll say is that, well, that could be anybody that's ever played for us wearing that number. So, there's little loopholes, but I think the players should be able to get a little cut if they're still, if their likeness is being used. What do you think?
Well, the Jordan brand uses North Carolina, and I've got Jordan jerseys from North Carolina that were just Nike profit. Did North Carolina see any of that money? I mean, I doubt that
probably not.
I just think that there's so much merchandise involved. That's a totally separate issue. I think that the Ed O'Bannon, I think the Ed O'Bannon issue has everything to do with the fact that after you are no longer an amateur, you should be able to see some profits. Mm-hmm. And if you can't see some profits from that, then something's going on.
And that's from, like, jerseys?
I'm not talking about jerseys, because I don't think a lot of people are wearing old Christian Laettner jerseys,
like,
as much.
Profit from what, then? Like, where?
Profits from the use of their imaging. So if Ed O'Bannon is being used in an NCAA commercial.
Like advertising?
In advertising.
Okay, yeah, that makes sense.
That is generating whatever kind of revenue it is. I don't know what the revenue stream is.
Yeah, I got you now, though. Yeah, I mean, it's...
And if Ed O'Bannon comes out and says, you cannot use my image, and they continue to use it, there must be some payment. There has to be.
Yeah, I get you now, yeah.
So,
yeah,
like the Christian Laettner. When Laettner turned around jumper, that we've seen every single year. Exactly. Does Laettner be able to get any of that? Or Grant Hill, because he made the pass? Or anybody else who's on the floor who has a part of that? Or is it solely the property of the NCAA? And because they're an amateur, they give up their right to have any accessibility to anything that they did while they were an amateur.
Yeah, it's kind of like working at a company and you think up some great idea while you're working there.
The company owns it, not you.
Yeah, the company owns it, not you. So
like Ed O'Bannon cutting down the nets and them showing that image, or him with the turnaround jumper with Laettner, the NCAA owns it. There's nothing that Laettner had. They have no rights. They worked for the NCAA. It's a tough issue, man.
Yeah.
So NCAA or the players?
I say NCAA, you know, after they graduate, maybe,
I think NCAA talk too. About,
but you know,
I think NCAA is going to win this one.
Yeah.
I vote for you though, Ed.
Yep. Ed O'Bannon, say what's up to your brother Charles for me. Yeah. The lefties, two lefties in the family, both super UCLA buttery kids. Yep. Real smooth.
Okay. Sports Chat 503. Thanks for visiting. Check out all the other YouTube videos. I think they're below us now.
Yep.
Adios.
Go Duke. Peace.